guys, welcome back for another true crime case this evening. We're going to jump right into it. Before you fall asleep, don't forget to like this video, comment on it, and subscribe. It helps me out so much, I can't even tell you. The case that we are discussing tonight is very recent. This happened last fall, so the fall of 2021. So keep that in mind. I believe that all of the updates have come out, but if anything changes, I will update. So today we are discussing the horrific murder of Miya Marcano. Miya was born in April of the year 2002, April 26th. Growing up, Miya was very close to her parents and her siblings. She had, that I could find, at least one brother and one sister. Now, her parents were divorced, but all sources say that she was very close to both parents, even though they divorced when she was only six. She was described by those close to her as funny, sarcastic, and full of life. She was also very athletic and very gorgeous. If you saw by the thumbnail, this girl was beautiful. After graduating high school, Miya moved from her hometown of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, Orlando, Florida, to attend Valencia College. In the year 2021, Miya was attending school and also was working at the apartment complex she lived at in their office, so that she could earn some income. September the 24th, 2021 started off as a great day for Miya. Miya liked to post on TikTok often, and that day was so excited because she had posted a dancing Never heard as her father. So both Marlins were really close by, and they followed him until they caught up with him and police got there, and they talked him into the police. He ended up letting them search his apartment, but they found nothing, not even that blanket that they had seen him take in to the apartment 10 minutes earlier. It is believed that his roommate disposed of it somewhere. With no evidence against Armando, they let him go. They kept looking for Maya, obviously, and that same day were pulling footage from the apartments and key fob data. So apparently this apartment, you had key fobs to get in, not a key. And all of the data was stored, and you could see who entered apartments at what time, which is a little freaky, but it was found that Armando used his master key to enter her apartment at 4:36 on September 24th. With this evidence, police go and try to arrest Armando for burglary at this point, but he had already run. 2 days later, on September the 27th, some maintenance workers at a nearby storage facility were trying to enter one of the storage units, and this was a previous employer of Armando. They were unable to get the door open like it had been locked from the inside somehow, like jammed shut. So they called the police, and when the police broke down the door, they found Armando deceased after he took his own life. After Armando's death, the police did not in any way give up searching for Maya. They were able to search his GPS coordinates, like in his phone, track him where he had been, and they found that on September 24th, a little after 5, he had left the apartment complex and drove 17 miles away to this very rundown remote location. It was a bunch of abandoned buildings, and there was this like intense overgrowth of kudzu and grass. And if you know what kudzu is, it takes over everything very fast. So it was a very big challenge to search this area. They searched for days and days. About 5 days into their search, they discover the body of Maya, very badly decomposed, pretty much only skeletal remains, but she had been in the Florida elements for 8 days at this point. Maya, when she was found, was wearing jeans a key to, like, a master. The master will be kept, and they will have to check it out when in work order is open. And so they know this guy has this key for this apartment on this day to better track. And it will also require extensive background checks to be done on maintenance workers or any workers. Now, Armando, this was a big thing for Maya's family. Armando did have an extensive violent criminal history and had a background check, a sufficient background check been done, he may not have, or likely wouldn't have been hired and in the position to do what he did to Maya. That is Maya's story. I'm thankful that the law is being set into motion. This is, to me, a lot like Jessica Haringa, who we talked about last week. Her family also